Hi and welcome to our second video following the Edexcel AS Biology. Today we're going to be looking at water and living organisms, and we're going to be looking at a few of its important features. Okay, so first of all, we're going to look at water's dipolar nature. So here we've got a molecule of water. We all know it has the symbol H2O, and the atoms are actually bonded covalently, so they're all sharing electrons. So what that actually means is that the oxygen is exerting a greater pull over those shared electrons. So because of that, we say that this end, so the hydrogen end, has a slightly positive charge, while the oxygen end, say up here, has a slightly negative charge. So we actually give it the symbol delta to show that. When you've got water molecules together, hydrogen bonds form between the oxygen, which is slightly negative, and the hydrogen, which is obviously slightly positive. And these hydrogen bonds are the attractions between those polar molecules. Now, many of water's properties or unique properties are down to this particular bond. So why is polarity or water's dipolar nature so important? Well, polar water molecules can obviously attract other water molecules, but they can also attract other ions and other polar molecules as well. Now, because of this attraction, water can actually dissolve many ionic compounds, so such as salts and other polar molecules like sugar as well. So basically, it's a good solvent. And it's a good solvent because of its polar nature. So here we've got an ionic compound. So this is obviously sodium chloride. And we can see that in its as an ion, the chlorine ion, you can see that the slightly positive sections or parts of water molecule are attracted and surround the chlorine ion like so, while the sodium ion, which has a positive charge, the negative part of water, which is obviously the oxygen part, surrounds the oxygen like that. And as you can quite clearly see, the more soluble a solute is, the easier it is for those ions to become isolated from each other. These dissolved particles are obviously now able to move around very easily, and so they can diffuse into and out of cells. So the next important property of water is that it's a good medium for metabolic reactions. So all metabolic reactions obviously take place within living things, and they need to occur within a solution, and that's usually the cytoplasm. So those moving particles are more likely to collide with one another, leading to a chemical reaction. Membranes and other biological surfaces are usually wet as well, and this allows the molecules to dissolve, including things like gases. So the alveoli, for example, the inner surface of the alveoli sacs are wet, and this allows oxygen to be dissolved on the membrane and can then diffuse into the blood. Water is also it's quite dense. So it's at its most dense when it's around, say, 4 degrees, and it starts to contract up to about 4 degrees Celsius. Then from 4 degrees to about 0 degrees, it actually starts to expand. Now, because of this, it prevents water from freezing from the bottom up. So in lakes, you'll actually see that ice starts to form on the surface of the water first, and that's because the freezing of the water releases heat to the water below, so it sort of insulates, or it acts as insulation. And it also means that the transition between the seasons is less abrupt. Okay, and what this diagram is showing is that obviously ice, so when water reaches 0 degrees, the water molecules actually become locked into this crystalline lattice. So each molecule of water is actually bonded onto four, or onto a maximum of four partners. Now, as the ice starts to melt, some of the hydrogen bonds break, and some water molecules can now start to slip closer together than they can while they were in the ice state. So ice is actually about 10% less dense than water at around 4 degrees Celsius. Okay, so that concludes this short presentation. Hope you enjoyed it, and don't forget to keep a lookout for some more videos coming up soon.